Comparing quantities, discounts and commissions. What is a discount? A discount is a reduction in price. It is usually offered as a percentage. You must have seen lots of discount signs at different places. So, a discount is a concession. It's the amount of money that is reduced from the original amount. We can express discount as an amount or we can express discount as a percentage. When we are talking about discount, let's make sure we know the basic terms related to discount. The cost price is the price that the shopkeeper got the item for. The marked price is the price that is on the tag of the item. Most of the times, the marked price is also the price that the person sells the item for. If there is a discount, then there is a concession on the marked price. So the marked price minus the discount is what the shopkeeper sells the item for. That price is then the selling price. So the selling price can be equal to the marked price, or the selling price can be lesser than the marked price. The discount is offered on the marked price. Let's try some word problems and understand how to calculate the discount. Let's read the problem first. A sari that is marked for Rs. 3000 is sold for a 10% discount. What is the selling price of the sari? You know that the discount is offered on the marked price. Here, it is Rs. 3000 and the rate of discount is 10%. So, the discount is 10% of Rs. 3000. Let's write this statement mathematically, that is, discount offered is equal to 10 upon 100 into 3000. We solve this and we get Rs. 300. This is the discount offered on the marked price. Therefore, the selling price is equal to marked price minus discount. That is equal to Rs. 3000 minus Rs. 300, which is Rs. 2700. And that is our answer. The selling price of the sari is Rs. 2700. Let's take a look at another one. An article is marked at Rs. 1600 during the Diwali festival and a 15% discount is allowed on it. What will its selling price be? You know that the discount is offered on the marked price. Here, it is Rs. 1600 and the rate of discount is 15%. So, the discount is 15% of Rs. 1600. Let's write this statement mathematically, that is, discount offered is equal to 15 upon 100 into 1600. We solve this and we get Rs. 240. This is the discount offered on the marked price. Therefore, the selling price is equal to marked price minus discount. That is equal to Rs. 1600 minus Rs. 240, which is Rs. 1360. And that is our answer. The selling price of the article is Rs. 1360. Let's take a look at another one. The marked price of a carpet is Rs. 750. The shopkeeper gives a discount of 20% on it. What is the selling price? You know that the discount is offered on the marked price. Here, it is Rs. 750. And the rate of discount is 20%. So, the discount is 20% of Rs. 750. Let's write this statement mathematically. That is, discount offered is equal to 20 upon 100 into 750. We solve this and we get Rs. 150. This is the discount offered on the marked price. Therefore, the selling price is equal to marked price minus discount. That is equal to Rs. 750 minus Rs. 150, which is Rs. 600. And that is our answer. The selling price of the carpet is Rs. 600. Let's now try something different. A watch is marked at Rs. 1150. During the off-season, the discount is given and it is sold for Rs. 1000. What is the discount percentage? You can see that the selling price is already given to us and we have to find the discount in percentage. The discount is offered on the marked price. Here, it is Rs. 1150. The selling price of the watch is Rs. 1000. So, to know the offered discount, we have to subtract the selling price from the marked price. That is, discount offered is equal to Rs. 1150 minus Rs. 1000, which is Rs. 150. Therefore, on Rs. 1150, the discount offered is Rs. 150. To get the discount percentage, we need to know what discount per 100. That is, we have to find out the discount offered on Rs. 100. Now let's set up the cross multiplication. Make the column of marked price and the discount. If the marked price is Rs. 1150, the discount is Rs. 150. Therefore, on Rs. 100, how much will be the discount? So we get 100 into 150 upon 1150, which gives us 13.04%. And that gives us the answer. The discount offered is 13.04%. Let's take a look at another one. A shopkeeper offers 10% discount on all his items. During the festive season, he decided to give a further discount of 20% over and above the existing price. Find the actual selling price of a suit of marked price Rs. 2500. The marked price is equal to 2500 and the discount offered is equal to 10%. Therefore, discount amount is equal to 2500 into 10 divided by 100. Which is equal to Rs. 250. Therefore, new price is equal to Rs. 2500 minus 250, which is equal to Rs. 2250. On this amount, the shopkeeper gives an extra discount of 20%. Therefore, discount amount is equal to 2250 into 20 divided by 100, which is equal to Rs. 450. Therefore, new price is equal to Rs. 2250 minus 450, which is equal to Rs. 1800. Therefore, the actual selling price of the suit is Rs. 1800. Let's take a look at another one. A shopkeeper offers 10% discount on all his items. During the festive season, he decided to give a further discount of 20% over and above the existing price. Find the marked price of a color television set which was sold at Rs. 10,080. Now selling price is equal to 10,080. Total discount is equal to 30%. Let's set up the cross multiplication. When selling price is 70, marked price is 100. When selling price is 10,080, what is the marked price? Therefore, we get 10,080 into 100 divided by 70, which is equal to 1,800 divided by 7, which is equal to 14,400. Hence, the marked price of the color TV set is Rs. 14,400. Let's take a look at another one. Marked price of a scooter is Rs. 47,500. It is sold for Rs. 43,700. What is the percentage of discount given? You can see that the selling price is already given to us and we have to find the discount in percentage. The discount is offered on the marked price. Here, it is Rs. 47,500. The selling price of the scooter is Rs. 43,700. So to know the offered discount, we have to subtract the selling price from the marked price. That is, discount offered is equal to rupees 47,500 minus rupees 43,700, which is rupees 3,800. Therefore, on rupees 47,500, the discount offered is rupees 3,800. To get the discount percentage, we need to know what discount per 100. That is, we have to find out the discount offered on rupees 100. Now let's set up the cross multiplication. Make the column of marked price and the discount. If the marked price is rupees 47,500, the discount is rupees 3,800. Therefore, on rupees 100, how much will be the discount? So we get 100 into 3,800 upon 47,500, which gives us 8%. And that gives us the answer. The discount offered is 8%. Let's take a look at another one. The price of a raincoat was reduced from rupees 960 to rupees 720 during a sale. What was the discount percentage offered? Discount in rupees is equal to original price minus reduced price, which is equal to rupees 960 minus rupees 720, which is equal to rupees 240. When the marked price is 960, the discount offered is 240. When the marked price is 100, what will be the discount? Which gives us 240 into 100 divided by 960, which is equal to 2400 divided by 96, which is equal to 25%. Hence, the discount offered is 25%. Let's take a look at another one. During a sale, a watch is sold for rupees 3000. The discount on the watch was 35%. What is the marked price of the watch? You can see that the discount offered is 35%. That is, if the marked price was rupees 100, discount would be rupees 35. And the selling price would be 100 minus 35, which is equal to rupees 65. If the selling price is rupees 65, marked price is rupees 100. And if the selling price is rupees 3000, what would be the marked price? We can now find the actual marked price by cross multiplication. And hence we get 100 into 3000 upon 65, which is equal to 4615.38. Therefore, the marked price of the watch is rupees 4615.38. Let's try one more of the same type. A shopkeeper gives a discount of 8% on the marked price of a camera. He sells the camera for rupees 460. What is the marked price? You can see that the discount offered is 8%. So, if the marked price was rupees 100, discount would be rupees 8. And the selling price would be rupees 100 minus rupees 8, which is equal to rupees 92. We can now find the actual marked price by cross multiplication. Now, let's set up the cross multiplication. If the marked price is rupees 100, the selling price would be rupees 92. What would be the marked price if the selling price is rupees 460? 100 into 460 upon 92, which is equal to rupees 500, and that gives us the answer. The marked price of the camera is rupees 500. You know what a discount is and how to do problems related to discounts. Now, let us take a look at commissions. What is a commission? A commission is a fee that we pay to an agent for the service that the agent provides. This fee is usually stated as a percentage. Let us solve some problems on commissions now. Sharda sold a fridge through an agent. Its price was 90,000. She had to pay a commission of 5%. How much did Sharda get for the fridge? Commission is offered on the selling price, that is, rupees 90,000. The rate of commission is 5%. So, commission is 5% of 90,000. Therefore, commission is equal to 5 upon 100 into 90,000, which is equal to Rs. 4,500. Sharda's price is equal to selling price minus commission. Therefore, Sharda's price is equal to 90,000 minus 4,500, which is equal to Rs. 85,500. Therefore, Sharda got Rs. 85,500 for the fridge. Let's take a look at another word problem. Vilas brought a plot of land through an estate agent for Rs. 4,50,000. If the agent commission is 2.5%, how much did Vilas have to pay the estate agent? Commission is offered on the selling price, that is Rs. 4,50,000. The rate of commission is 2.5%. So, commission is 2.5% of 4,50,000. Therefore, commission is equal to 2.5 upon 100 multiplied by 4,50,000, which is equal to 11,200. Therefore, estate agent's commission is Rs. 11,250. Let's take a look at another one. Joshi bought a toaster for Rs. 6,500 through an agent. After paying the agent, Joshi had spent Rs. 6,630. What is the agent's rate of commission? Commission is offered on the selling price, that is Rs. 6,500. Therefore, commission is equal to Rs. 6,500 minus Rs. 6,630, which is equal to Rs. 130. When selling price is Rs. 6,500, commission is Rs. 130. So, if the selling price is Rs. 100, what would be the commission? Set up the cross multiplication and get the answer. 100 into 130 upon 6500, which gives us 2. That means for every 100, the commission is Rs. 2. That means the rate of commission is 2%. Did you understand discounts and commissions? Yes!
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.